two men in court today suspected of multiple burglaries around the region. Two Winooski men are caught in the act trying to break into a house in Charlotte. Good evening, everyone. I'm Stephanie Gorin.
And I'm George Mallet. But once police caught up with the suspected crooks, the pair spilled the beans on a laundry list of other crimes. The two are now prime suspects in a string of Chittenden and Franklin County burglaries.
News Channel 5's Charlie Gora joins us live with the crime beat tonight. Charlie.
Steph, how are you? Thomas Savard and Joshua Greenough pleaded not guilty to burglary and trespassing charges. Now, according to police, the duo admitted to committing a series of break-ins, with Greenough acting as the getaway driver and Savard going into the homes. But it would all come to an end on a quiet road in Charlotte.
We are living in Vermont. We all think it's basically a safe and friendly place, and so we tend to relax.
But Leslie Botchin says that might change. On Wednesday, she got a call from her neighbor. She told her she saw two men leaving the neighbor's house as she pulled in the driveway.
They gave her a story as to the reason that they were there. None of the pieces of the story fit in her mind very well, and at that point, she did call 911, I believe.
Police caught up with the two men shortly after near Whaley Road in Charlotte.
Through some interviews, we were able to develop more information and then place these subjects under arrest.
Arrested were Joshua Greenough and Thomas Savard, both of Winooski.
On the public reading of the charges, entered pleaded not guilty on both dockets.
And while both pled not guilty to a series of burglary charges, court papers indicate Greenough and Savard admitted to police their involvement in a wave of break-ins, including this house in Westford and homes in Jericho, Underhill, and Colchester. Savard's attorney asked the court to release his client into the custody of a guardian because of his cooperation with the police. The judge disagreed.
The significant amount of jail time, potential jail time he's facing, the court agrees with the state that there's a substantial risk of flight.
Savard was held on $25,000 bail, while Greenough, who according to the police affidavit was mainly the getaway driver, was held on $15,000 bail. Both are due back in court at the end of October.
A little bit more information from the police affidavit. The two were also allegedly selling some of their stolen goods to a collectibles shop at a local mall. Live in the newsroom this evening, Charlie Gora, News Channel 5.